Prisons in Minecraft. For a long time, they were bedrock boxes and adventure maps, but as of late, the Minecraft prison community has grown and started to make bigger and better prisons that work in survival. Cool as they are, there is one problem. At its core, the prison is always the same, using Elder Guardians, your respawn point, and regenerating cobblestone to trap the player. But what if these were all removed? In this video, I challenge myself to make 5 different prisons. The rules are, I can't use Elder Guardians, cobblestone, or beds in my prison. I also come up with all my ideas independently. Let us begin. Number 1. Starting simply, pistons are one of the best ways to trap a player. If a piston moves a player while they are mining a block, the mining starts over, making breaking out of this cell almost impossible. You probably think I should just break the exposed piston, but when the piston extends, the mining gets cut off. It would be possible to break out of the walls if you have the right tools or AI levels of mouse tracking. So using what I learned earlier, I made this design. All the walls and floors are made out of pistons, which extend in synchronization. Using 2 identical wall designs and an observer clock in the floor, I give these piston designs an A tier because of how simple and cheap they are to build. I would happily use this on an SMP, which can't be said for some of the others we'll look at. Water is a really useful block for prison builders. It slows your mining speed, but more importantly, your movement speed. Using magma and soul sand blocks, hooked up to a redstone loop, I made a prison design based on a water elevator. It works by pushing the player away from the blocks being mined, too fast to break them. Down to some testing, I found the prison had a flaw. The player can swim by double tapping W. If they can swim, they can glitch out when the pistons change. To fix this, I added a husk and regenerating beacons to the cell. Husks give you hunger when you get hit, and low enough hunger bars stop you from swimming, making this cell watertight. Moving on. Having made 2 functional prisons, I decided to make my 3rd prison more interesting. I made a prison using TNT. It's composed of a simple player launcher and a dispenser firing slow-falling arrows. When a player is launched into the cobwebs at the top, a redstone signal is sent up and the dispenser starts firing arrows, giving the player slow-falling. A pufferfish player detector automatically detects when they fall to the bottom, and the cycle repeats. They are kept alive by some Curse of Binding armor and a regenerating beacon. I would rank this prison a C tier because of how expensive it's to run and how hard it was to build. Shulkers are, in my opinion, an underused mob. They can make a base in the void, disable all mob spawning, but more importantly, can give you levitation. With a lot of buttons and 2 shulkers, I made this prison design. The shulkers are on opposite sides of you, so if you try to kill one of them, the other will just hit you and send you flying. A dispenser behind one of the shulkers heals them, making them pretty much unkillable. This is good, but if resources aren't a problem, we can take this to the next level. I made this design entirely out of unkillable shulkers. It needs about 10 stacks of potions per minute, and some Curse of Mining armor, which needs to be repaired every so often, but it works, and that's enough for me. Well, I guess that's the end of the video. That's 4 prisons in Minecraft. Yeah, I think I'm gonna end it here. Wait, what's that? The 5th type of prison? There's nothing here. What is this? What? What? No, wait! I was kidding! Oh. Well, now I'm floating in the eternal void, I guess I better tell you about the 5th prison. In all the prisons I've built so far, I've been holding back. In reality, a prison just keeps someone away. The safest way to do this is to send them to orbit. While they're falling, you technically imprison them, as there's no way to escape. This can be done using commands and levitation like you just saw. or in older versions using thousands of end crystals to send you as far away as possible. Eventually you will fall back down to Earth, but by then your sentence should be over. If you can't do this, just send your prisoner as far as possible the other way. To the void. Using commands and potion effects, you can survive in the void and fall for all eternity. After that, there's no way back. You can't place box, pearl, or fly. It turns out the best prison is your addiction to block games. Hey, now that the video is over, can I say two things? One, thank you for watching to the end, and two, I have zero subs, so if anyone wants to be the first or third counting unsubs, you get a place in my channel description. Thanks for watching.